The total is $14.7 million, and the research is tobacco-related research. The first grant that we want to announce is a $10.7 million grant from the American Heart Association. Dr. Bhatnagar, who we were with a little over a month ago for the other announcement, he is the co-PI, along with the Chief Science Officer for the American Heart Association, Dr. Rosemarie Robertson, who is with us, and you'll hear from her in just a moment. This is part of funding provided to the American Heart Association by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration and the National Institute of Health to fund tobacco-related research by creating 14 tobacco centers for regulatory science.
One of the most difficult things is dealing with what are the underlying causes of heart disease. And we know that diabetes, hypertension, so high blood pressure, obesity, smoking, and a whole variety of factors are related to that, but we don't know exactly why. And the underpinnings of disease really mandate that we understand that if we're going to effectively prevent it. And that really is the subject of these grants.
The first project is to understand which constituents, components, and design characteristics of cigarettes and other tobacco products, particularly smokeless tobacco, contribute to the harm induced by smoking. Although nicotine is a very powerful stimulant, it affects the brain, it affects blood pressure, there are other constituents in tobacco smoke that may be even more lethal or more problematic than nicotine. So a normal cigarette contains over 4,000 different chemicals, and we are trying to understand which of these chemicals contribute to the harmful effects of smoking and to what level. The second project that we have is to look at this in a large population study. So as Dr. Robertson mentioned, we have ongoing, this center would have collaborations with the New York University, with Boston University, Johns Hopkins, Emory, I think University of Michigan, and University of Northwestern Chicago. And so we will be able to set up a consortium of investigators to look at these large, what we call cohort studies, to study what particular features of cardiovascular disease are affected by tobacco. Project three, which is the forte of the American Heart Association, is to look at what communication channels do people use to communicate issues related to tobacco.
When the HA decided that we should apply for one of these centers, we looked around the country and we looked at people who were AHA volunteers and scientists who weren't our volunteers as well. We have 30,000 professional members in all fields that work with us, so we had a lot of people to look at. And it was clear to us that Dr. Bhatnagar and the team he has assembled was absolutely the place to go. And as I was saying to him last night, my first drive up here from Nashville was clearly a drive in the right direction, because that was the drive to come up and see if I could recruit him to work on this with us. We're just delighted with the program that's been put together. We're excited to work with the other centers and with the other universities as well, Boston University, the University of Mississippi, New York University. We have many groups that are going to work with us on this, but really the center of this is here at the University of Louisville.